Nicodemus asked, "How can a grown man ever be born a second time?" Jesus answered, "I tell you for certain that before you can get into God's kingdom, you must be born not only by water, but by the Spirit. Humans give life to their children, yet only God's Spirit can change you into a child of God. Don't be surprised when I say that you must be born from above. Only God's Spirit gives new life. The Spirit is like the wind that blows everywhere it wants to. You can hear the wind, but you don't know where it comes from or where it is going." Those words come from John chapter 3, verses 4 to 8. Being baptized and being born again are quite similar. Usually, when those two things are mentioned in the same sentence, the discussion then goes on to establish the relationship or lack of relationship between the two. For the purpose of this comment, I choose to ignore that topic and focus on something that rarely is noticed with being baptized and being born again. Being baptized and being born again are things that happen to you, not things that you do or even can do yourself. You cannot baptize yourself, and you cannot cause yourself to be born again. Actually, your role is to allow those things to happen. You may decide to be baptized, but if there's no one to baptize you, it will not happen. You may also decide to be born again, but unless the Holy Spirit does it, it will not happen. So all the things you must do to be saved are simply acts of submission to God and His Spirit. When your new birth happens, it is truly nothing less than the power of God applied to your life so that you might be changed into the image of His Son and live with Him forever. The Holy Spirit delivers you from this world and its wickedness and plants your feet firmly in the kingdom of heaven. Lord Jesus, I thank you for bringing eternal life to lost sinners. I choose this day to obey you and your every word. Do to me whatever you choose. And may your name be praised forever. Amen.